is more. See, he believed in stripping architecture down to simplicity. And for him, that was usually just simple steel and glass, usually black box design. But of course, you can't miss these two spiral towers here to our right. These are collectively known as Marina City, affectionately referred to as the Corncob Towers. Now, these were completed in 1964, designed by the architect Bertrand Goldberg. Now, Goldberg, he loved to use nature as his inspiration. And one of his famous quotes, "There are no right angles in nature." So he tried very hard to keep them out of his buildings. Hence you get these circular, almost flower petal-like shape to the Marina City Towers. Now up top, that's where you got your residences. Below that, your parking garages. Below that, you got restaurants, the marina. There's an old office building that's part of this that's now a hotel. The old movie theater is now the House of Blues. Essentially, you can think of this as a city within a city. And it was designed that way on purpose. See, back in the 1960s, a lot of people had left Chicago for the suburbs. You know, they might work downtown, but many didn't necessarily want to live downtown. So Goldberg designed the complex to really have all the amenities you could possibly want kind of one convenient location. Oh, by the way, if you have an image of maybe a car flying out of the parking garage of Marina City into the river, that has happened. In a movie. Yeah, The Hunter with Steve McQueen is where they did that stunt. There was also an insurance commercial they recreated it. No, they've always had valet parking in those garages, so you've never had to figure it out. Unless there's the chance of an accident happening. Oh, I do want to mention a little bit about the bridge houses. Each bridge has anywhere from 1 to 4 bridge houses. You need at least one to house the controls for it. Some of them very ornately designed, some of them much more simple. It's often a reflection of the era that the bridge might have been built in. We actually do have a bridge house museum in the city over at Michigan Avenue. It just opened up for the season this weekend, so you can actually go inside. Now take a look here to the right. You have this red brick building with the clock tower, the Reed Murdoch Center. As you're looking at it, you might notice it's uneven, meaning the right side has 6 bays of windows. The left side only has 5. Now that's not how it originally was. See, when this opened as a warehouse in 1914, nice and even, 6 on either side. And then they were expanding LaSalle Street here ahead of us, and they actually cut off part of that building. And to me, that is a perfect example of Chicago progress. Especially in early 20th century. Nothing got in its way, not even your warehouse. Now, not a warehouse anymore. They have restaurants in there, a bunch of office space. That's known as adaptive reuse. When you take an old structure, update it for modern needs. In fact, you'll see another great example of that here to our right. The other remaining warehouse structure on the main branch is this red and gray brick building. It started out as a coffee warehouse in the 19-teens. And then in the 1980s, they gutted and remodeled the interior, added these glass office penthouses up top. In fact, that's where you'll find the DIRTT design firm. Stands for Doing It Right This Time. Yeah, they specialize in environmentally friendly interior designs.